very large and important work for me. Again, a family painting, the Shergill family from my mother's side.
Vivan?
Painted it over 2 years. Took a lot out of me. In some way, the scale produced a certain formality, a certain kind of distance. Signs of fire, a forest fire, the whole hillside ablaze, overlapped as an image. Mixed media and collage. Plains of Punjab burning. A series of charcoal drawings started off on a visit to Auschwitz. The quality of the landscape, a kind of subterranean, a very dark and very bleak journey taking place. Many of the images quite abstract, didn't have any sense of location. Could feel images about war in some sense, the Second World War, images of nuclear holocaust, of violence has scorched our own situation. And once that is over, the paintings again form part of the desire to return to a very direct human, sensuous, palpable experience. Thank you. It's such a large mural, don't make it too depressing. We've had a long history of friendship, of doing, in the sense of exhibitions together, or participating in activities in a different ways, but not actually working together.
I thought that working on a canvas, we all won't be able to participate the way we did in glass painting. So we thought we'll be able to forget our egos and work together.
हम भी अच्छे तुम भी अच्छी वाली बात हो गई.
Baroda is a small town compared to Bombay. I've been working in Baroda since last 28 years. I think temples, mosques, churches are very much part of our living. They form essential part of my painting. These gods and goddesses are almost next door neighbors or someone who stays upstairs. Naturalistic painting has not interested me. My interest is mostly in the narrative painting. The time sequence in painting interests me. In 1970-71, I started doing paintings based on professions. I used the colors that were used by middle class people, particularly shocking pink, green and blue. I'm happy with these paintings, though I did not sell these paintings for a long time. I used the things around us. I used colors of posters, garish and vulgar. At present, I am interested in play of light in my painting, the way light falls on objects, the way things get illuminated. I have been collecting this oleograph since 1962. Right in the beginning, the things which I had collected are from the cinema posters, the gods and goddesses posters, and also very late miniatures. All these things had interested me. These things have been ignored because they were considered as things which are on periphery of art. The earlier work, like a tailor, watch repairer, is a satire on the existing work being done. Certain things which I thought I had no courage to say, I needed some courage to say. So I had used totally different way of approaching the problem. Slowly, I could gather the courage and say these things. Things which interested me started coming. The problems of transvestite, problems of homosexuality, problems of so many things, which I was not able to depict on the canvas. Slowly, I could do it in the later work.
Although I do paint things about people who are on the street, I don't go down onto the street and sketch. What I like to do is observe as much as I can, or at least incorporate in my mental space much that I see around me and I have been seeing around me for the 12 years that I have worked in this studio, and then come back to my studio and recall all that I have observed. And this is how I actually work. I mean, I like the stress of recall. I like the stress of, you know, the strain of recalling from memory, pulling it through various screens almost, and then bringing forth a figure. started working on the watercolors in 1983, and the idea started because I had to vacate my studio, which was under repair, and had a very small space to work in at my home. And it was really starting in a very small way, in a very small format. So it was at this point that I started to do the watercolors. After having done a whole series, I showed them to a friend, Rima Sheikh, and she introduced me to the works of an artist, a Turkish artist called Siya Kalam, which she felt it was important for me to see at that point. And I think that was really something fantastic. Siya Kalam is a series of pictures done by Turkish nomadic artists of the 15th century, wandering in the deserts and recording the nomadic lives of the tribes of that area. And with the poverty of means, it's simply washes of sepia and bunsen, you know, and Persian blue. Even little flecks of gold at times, I guess when they had little money, they could just afford to put a little bit of gold in. With just this, they were able to record the most marvelous things, you know, dervishes and fakirs, and I think that was for me a revelation. Series about conversations with artists of the past who have played a vital role in my art perceptions. The works entitled Rethinking Raja Ravi Varma and Marsha and the Vermeer Women are from this series. The picture entitled Of Monsters and Angels, a Fable, is about reinventing figures from the miniature painting traditions and placing them in post-colonial times, signified by the appearance of the Occidental angel. Another set of pictures manifests the city, my city, Bombay. The areas and locales that I encounter every day. Beneath the mundane skin lies an alternate world which reveals itself only when it is not being looked at. That is, when it is absorbed in itself and does not rise to meet your gaze. I'm curious about the possibility of painting states of one's mind. I do not wish to be mystical at all. By states of mind, I'm referring to emotions that grip one in the ordinary context of one's life, like oppression, anxiety, self-absorption, anger. When I paint this figure, I put in the posture all at once with a loaded brush, like a mark. And that mark has in it the germ of the stoop, the gesture, the facial expression, all of it incorporated in that very instant. I do pictures of the human face out of a passionate obsession. These are faces of people I have been meeting for many years. I walk down my street where my studio is situated in Lohar Chal. It is the Pachiwala waiting in the rain for a quick assignment, or the boys who run errands for the ODP restaurant, or the old widow who I meet going up and down the stairs, who lives in her memories of being an actress at one time. I do not know whether this is truth or fantasy. I'm obsessed with getting into these people that have secret lives that I will never know.
A series of pastels called Journeys, very joyous works. The whole thing about journeys, sea journeys, leaving one's shores, exploring other people's, other cultures, a lot of them 19th century, fantasy travels, a range of possibilities that excites me. These journeys started off as abstract works, but the latter ones concretized, having a certain geography, a certain place, a reference to a certain time. Going to the opposite of starting with abstraction and then making a kind of story or a narrative. I'd like to go out, fantasy journeys, and then come back home, and then leave again. Many of the paintings that I do, I think about for sometimes for years. I get an image in my head, and that image I ruminate about, I make sketches, and it might be 2 or 3 years later that I actually come about to do that painting. Of course, many changes take place. But the painting at the moment is a constructed artifact. It is something that I put together from this kind of long history that I have of this image or images that make the painting. The landscape in Kasauli has become a very central feature of my work. By landscape, I also include the human beings. And in fact, over the last 20 years since I've been coming here, many local people that I have established a very close personal contact have become a very important feature of my work. The way that the colors come in, the way the quality of the light, the kinds of textures that are there, where the landscape then becomes a grand metaphor. In 1980, I did a portrait of my father, a turning point in my work. There'd been considerable crisis, the crisis about bringing the human figure in. From that point, a series of paintings evolved, set the pattern which still exists today in the oil paintings that I'm doing. The desire to have as large a spectrum in terms of my subject matter, where I do allow the personal characters, friends of mine, to be subject matter of painting, which has been the modernist movement anathema. You don't paint your friends or your beloved or your family members.